Can you make it?
Is it a weapon? Armor? Or likewise an instrument of war, of which I'm a master at shaping? No? Then forget it. Even if I wanted to make such an insignificant gewgaw, I'm liable to chink my tools working on something so delicate and ladylike.
Then shingle it. Pattern weld the item with scap slag. Keep the layers thin. Alternate the overlay.
Okay, smart guy. And where do you propose to find a lump of quality scap slag? Last time I saw one, I could still get rigid down south. Shut your mouth, is that? Where did you?
I had to get my hands dirty.
Well, don't just stand there. Let's do this.
What? You? You're fine with working on something that's not a weapon?
Oh, hell, why not? What? I can grow too.
Oh, watch the spine. Keep your wrist loose.
No, you keep your wrist loose. Yeah, I need more heat here.
Coming up. You gonna temper that steel longer?
I don't need to. I triple quenched it with Draugr.
See? How inventive and sanitary. You clever little beaver. Never too late to learn a new trick, is it?
No, it's not. Yeah.
Here it is.
Nope. Don't forget this. No, quit your grinning. It's downright unsettling.
It's just nice to see you together. But now the rune on your brand looks different.
Yeah, price of reforging something what broke.
I knew it. You two love each other.
Oh, cut it out, Princess. You're gonna get me all weepy.
I like the new one better. Don't you?
We have work to do.
No. My brother and me got a new project, now that we're on speaking terms.
What do you want?
With the whetstone and hammer you've retrieved for us, Brock and I can construct the Dvegrathiker, dwarven armor of legend.
We just need three more mythical ingredients before we set to hammer.
Which are?
Dunno. Armor's pure legend, and the details is fuzzier than a wolver's butthole.
You expect us to find parts from a legend?
Oh, Motsognir the Dwarf King found two of them. Everyone knows that. But when he went looking for the third...
Poof! He vanished. Maybe he'll find some clues at his stronghold in Konungsgard.
And looky here. A Konungsgard entry stone. It's got your name on it. How fucking strange. Okay. The stronghold's northwest of here, behind the Svartalfheim Realm Tower.
Large stone structure, creepy atmosphere. You'll know it when you see it. The Huldra brothers, back in action again. Oh, I can't wait to get started.
Never think I'd see such a day we was back to building as a duo. But it feels right. Especially for this. Been so used to building on my own all these years, almost forgot how dang useful an extra pair of hands is.
I forgot how much easier it is to smelt scap slag with someone else gauging the temperature.
keep them from hacking bits off you. About that other thing. Let's sort you out. That's it.
We just need to figure out which door this key opens. It has to be somewhere. I always heard that Baldur's mother was Frigg.
Aye, Frigg. Well, that's more of a pet name, you see. It means beloved. Something Odin called Freya after they wed. Out of affection at first, or so I like to believe. As things turned sour, it became a way to manipulate the truth.
How so?
Odin didn't want Freya, a Vanir goddess, getting credit for anything in Asgard. So anything worthy she accomplished was attributed to Frigg.
Like being Baldur's mother.
That's right. Freya was Baldur's mother all along.
Wow. I'm glad. why Brock and Sindri were able to work out the differences.
Now they are twice as irritating.
Ah, I think it's nice to see them trust each other again. Namir, why did you say Tyr felt responsible for what Odin did to the Giants?
There was an incident. Shortly after the forging of Mjolnir, when Tyr arranged a diplomatic meeting between Odin and the Giant Kings. Well, this was when the Long War was young, when victory was still a thing dreamed of and the Jotnar might have tipped the balance between Aesir and Vanir. Odin had persuaded Tyr that the hammer was merely a deterrent, a means to broker peace from a position of strength. Tyr was hopeful to convince all parties they would prosper best through peace. He knew the Giants were deeply concerned about the hammer, a super weapon in hands they did not trust. But they trusted Tyr.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad.
Boy.
It says, glory to Motsignir, the Dwarf King. May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace.
Greetings, and welcome to Konungsgard. I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break.
Whoa. Look, it's another dragon.
I see it, boy.
Chain. I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge.
Focus up, boy.
The Dwarf King captured more than one dragon. He must have needed them to create this legendary army.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Really everything about dragons is useful. It contains power. Teeth, scales, even excrement.
Excrement?
Shit.
Dragon shit is powerful?
Aye, lad. Potently powerful.
The head is having fun with you.
Oh, I knew that.
Doesn't fall far.
That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them, at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh.
Huh!
What?
Yeah.
Stone number two. This place is even bigger than Vaedergard.
Yes. The Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
Wonder what happened to him.
'Tis a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Mozognir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic.
Why?
The Dvegrath Eater, the very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness.
Thank you.
is. She is? Are you girl, Dantes?
I do not know.
There are a few ways to find out, but they're rather messy.
I guess it doesn't matter.
How we're trying to free it. Tasker, at your fucking service. Eat this!
Ah!
go!
Here. Boy.
Yes, sir. Interesting.
Again with this shit!
Reddit Oscar saves the day! Again!
It is over.
Come here. Why did the dwarf thing want this armor so badly? What's so special about it?
There are many legends behind the Dvegrath Ikar. A suspicious amount of legends. Which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
Well, what can you trust?
Yourself, your eyes, your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble. Barely does it pay off.
Yes, sir.
Atreus, to me.
Looks like it needs three entry stones. Still won't open? Looks like we need three. Here we go. Huh. It's kind of run down in here.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Less ruin, I guess? Maybe the throne room's in better shape.
Look here. Another.
Starcatter. Wow, that's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
Six, seven, eight? Could he shoot four bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the two eyes.
It looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. Large crowd of people.
Just old spirits, I suppose. Leftover victims of the Mad Dwarf's rage.
They're getting louder. They sound almost like... of Hellwalkers. Hey, look at this. A blood trail. Run to Duster!
I guess this is my life now.
Seriously? Please stop. Please, I'm begging you.
Where's a passage behind this throne?
A secret passage.
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Here, boy.
Huh, interesting. I may want to write that down.
Whoa.
The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. If you want sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
what this place looked like in better times.
Conan's Guard was a beautiful land in its heyday, before the Dwarf King's obsession poisoned his mind.
How could he let that happen?
The dwarf blindly trusted in the legend and pursued it without thought to the consequences. This is the result.
Trust is a gamble. Like you said, and the Dwarf King lost. Tell me again how Odin knew we were going to Jotunheim before we did.
Odin is extremely clever, you see. Nearly as clever as he thinks he is. And he's a collector of prophecies. If it's about the future, he adds it to his collection. Helps him style himself as all-seeing and all-knowing. But of course, the idea is control. Control of the future, control of his fate. He'd control every realm of every land in every world if he could. Every potential pocket of resistance, he seeks to eliminate. Even if you've never posed a threat before, he may think one day you might. So you see, it's not important how he knew before you did. It's important that he was right.
Wow.
You boys look right beaming. Well, the squirt does. Can't see squat behind that frizzle fuzz you call a beard.
We found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so... so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.
Something else we can do for you?
Nah, just glad you guys worked it out.
Ah, well, I could say the same to you.
I guess I was getting a bit full of myself.
Told him what he needed to hear, how's it sounds to me.
Just the same. I'm sorry for how I spoke to you, Sindri. You forgive me?
Already have. Like you said, it all worked out. Now, let us get back to work before I get... sentimental.
Let's get to it. we'll scuff that up. Bitch. You hitting the road or chewing the fat?
Atreus, follow me.
Be right there.
Tyr's rune. This is it.
We're inside. But what is this place?
Your guess is as good as mine, little brother.
The tree! We're underneath the realm travel room. Why is the floor on the ceiling?
Those realm doors seem to mirror the ones above.
Use the same magic to protect the Black Rune. The clue we seek may be inside.
Huh. Right next to the Unison door.
Interesting. But can we reach it?
Not from here.
Oh! What's behind there?
Well, one inner sanctum within another.
Those tapestries. Looks like more giant art. Whatever it here did for them must have been big. Whoa, who are they?
Boy, this is the rune for Jotunheim.
That's right. And look, we're on the other side of the door.
The upside down door.
What are you thinking?
Stand back.
Okay. It's moving!
What's moving?
Everything!
Extraordinary. The whole room is built on some kind of axle.
There's chains on both sides. Without those...
We can flip the temple.
All right!
Do you... what now?
Attacking. Want me to read this one?
Boy, on the statues.
I see them. It says boy.
Ominous.
Go on, read.
Before the first, after the last. Nothing between, no shadow cast. Alpha.
Are you quite sure flipping the temple is the only way to reach them, whatever it is?
You said there would be a path. The temple can be flipped.
Therefore, we flip the temple. The logic is unassailable. Not sure what happens when we recklessly upend a room that's rooted to eight other realms. I'm curious, of course, but it's a leap to imagine it gets us to Jotunheim.
I don't mind a leap.
Well, who knows? Perhaps you and Tyr are the same kind of mad.
Here, boy. Another one.
It says his name is Bergomir. I think Mother said he was the king of the giants.
Aye, that he was. And quite a bit more.
Looks like he had a lot of kids.
That, little brother, is what we call an understatement.
He's dead, but nobody killed him. Do giants die from old age?
They may, though it's rare among the legends. Again with the death traps. I'd have thought, brother. Why don't you let the lad carry me for a while?
And let you miss this? No.
You're enjoying this, aren't you? Time to do what you do, brother.
Now we can decipher those Niflheim rings. And the travel rune is here too. You wanna go? Leave them in peace.
Obviously not referring to us.
chain waits.
Ah, it's the other kind. Variety is so important. I truly do hate this part.
I know.
For one, never doubted.
Right. Until gods grow good.
Could be quite a wait.
Nah. They're just waiting for us.
Thank you.
Time to flip the temple.
Yes, sir.
Let's just agree to stop saying flip the temple. It's starting to sound normal. Brothers, I know what I promised, but in case this doesn't work, just remember, Tyr had good cause to create these obstacles. He's kept Jotunheim out of Odin's reach, but the world is hardly at peace.
No, but it's got hope. We're all working together now. We have unity. That's what the rune on the door to this place was telling us. We're on Tyr's path.
Lift with your legs, brother.
He knows.
Just trying to be helpful. Sir, I'll be quite happy to be on your side, brother. And we're not dead. That's a plus.
There, on the left. I think we can climb back up to the realm travel room from there.
A climb, you say?
Aye, by the statues.
Atreus, here!
See that, Mimir? Nobody can do all this alone. All these obstacles, they're just chances to prove we're the ones who can beat them. We may argue. Me and Father, you and Freya, Brock and Sindri. But when we all work together, we do make a good team. And that's Tyr's test. That's why we're gonna make it to Odin.
Do you hear that, brother? Man's found his equilibrium.
What's that mean?
He means you speak wisely, Atreus. And that is good to hear. Roy, your knife.
Well, what have we got?
Some sort of travel stone.
Let me see. Great Outhumblers at us. That's the Unity Stone.
You know it.
I wasn't sure it existed. If Tyr possessed this, that explains how he could visit all the realms and other lands to boot.
He held this in the panel in Odin's library.
Yes. Yes, that's it. I understand now. It shows Tyr walking the realm between realms. You know how you must never stray from the path? Well, Tyr always followed his own path, if you catch my meaning.
The realm between realms.
So you're saying Tyr's shrine showed him stepping off the branch of the world tree. And you're thinking, to reach the secret path to Jotunheim, that's what we need to do?
I am.
Oh dear. That is what you're thinking, isn't it? If you're thinking about hurling us all into the void, I hope you're quite sure.
Wasn't it your idea? Find your own path, right?
Bollocks.
This is where Tyr stepped beyond, and the Unity Stone protected him. Ready?
Ready.
Well, if this is it, lads, it's been an honor.
Our faith, Head.
How can I be so nauseous without a stomach?
Come on, that was great.
Look.
The tower. I knew there was something down here.
Amazing. How do you hide something that exists in all realms? Cast it out of any realm to the space between. Clever old Tyr.
Is Jotunheim on the other side?
Can't be that. It's not like you go through Vanaheim to reach the Midgard Peak.
But how do we use it?
I'd suggest we look inside, but stay alert. Tyr's little challenges are never as simple as they appear.
I have noticed.
Well, this is sparse.
The pedestal.
Oh no! It took the stone!
The tower. It's absorbing the stone's energy.
Something's happening! Is it moving? It's moving!
It knows what to do. The stone served its purpose. We're fulfilling Tyr's spell.
What happens now?
No idea, brother. But after that fall, I'm sure we're past the worst of it.
Sounds like Niflheim.
This is considerably worse.
Watch out, Father!
Dear, here they come.
There's the bridge! We did it! The tower's back where it belongs!
Now Tyr's travel room can take us to Jotunheim.
How did Tyr do this?
Odin suspected the giant secretly possessed some remnant of primordial Jotnar creative essence, the stuff all realms were made of. The Unity Stone must have been fashioned from that essence. To trust an outsider with it, even Tyr, tells you just how desperate they were.
And look! Now we can finally light all the braziers and see what happens. Another name. Going to...
Another Valkyrie. That's no coincidence. But who'd have etched them on Tyr's braziers? I don't know what we'll find when we get to Jotunheim, but we must cover our tracks. Odin's ravens will tell him of the tower's restoration, and we mustn't let our efforts be to his benefit.
Very well.
Wait a minute. This isn't going to work.
What?
There's no travel crystal. Tyr must have used his own eyes to refract the energy. It was his final failsafe.
You've got eyes like him, Amir.
I've got an eye. One! Odin plucked out my other eye precisely to keep me from traveling. Sorry, lads. Thought that would work.
What did Odin do with your other eye?
He'd have kept it in any of 100 places, I'm afraid.
We've come so far. There has to be a way.
Look, bit of a long shot, but for years I'd see Sindri, sometimes Brock, lurking around in that mountain when Odin came for his visits. Maybe they know something.
Brock and Sindri! Guys, question for you. Anyone know where we can find Mimir's other eye?
Oh. That's... I'm sorry. As a matter of fact, Odin asked me to... He wanted me to build a... He showed it to me, you see, and I... Sorry, will you excuse me? Oh.
Well, that was useless.
You know, it was about that same time that Odin came around looking for me to build a statue with some sort of hidden compartment. Now, that not being a weapon and the Aesir being a bunch of pox-speckled cockers, I too saw fit to decline. But I know he got it built just the same.
What was the statue?
It's that one of Thor out there flashing his sack to the lake.
The statue that the serpent ate.
Sorry about that. Feeling much better.
How are we supposed to look inside the snake?
Inside?
We'd better go see what the world serpent has to say about that. Well, lads, I don't know what lies ahead, but now would be a good time to make sure your gear is ready for the worst. Anything you need to do, I'd do it now. Just some sage advice. sure it's nothing. He just said the boy seemed familiar to him.
Me? That's impossible.
No, I quite agree. Unless, perhaps, he refers to something yet to be. It is said that when Jormungandr and Thor battle at Ragnarok, their clash so violently shakes the Tree of Life that it splinters, casting the serpent backward through time, even before his own birth.
What?
That is madness.
Well, I did say not to concern yourself. Niflheim. Not sure why anyone would want to come here, but here we are.
It smells bad. What is this stuff?
This mist is cursed.
Cursed?
Quite right. Safe to breathe for a time, but it'll kill if we linger. Just one more reason to love Niflheim.
Here. Boy.
Let's see. What is that stuff? Weird.
Yes. A strange material.
Fancy seeing you two here.
I'm surprised you're here, Sindri. This mist is pretty gross.
You think I can't handle a little cursed mist? Well, you're right. I'm trying to build some armor that will lessen its effects. The materials I need are all right here in Ivaldi's workshop, but they're blanketed by this nauseating mist, of course.
Wait for it.
The last known location for such armor is in the workshop's center chamber. The entrance is sealed, but I could craft you an entry stone with enough mist echoes.
There it is.
I wouldn't recommend staying in the mist for too long. That stench will stick to your hair, your weapons, your armor. And I will not touch your gear until you burn all the tiny beasties off in the fires of Muspelheim. Also, it will kill you.
There's something written here. This whole place shuffles around each time we leave? That's incredible.
Atreus, focus. This is a dangerous place.
That's dwarven creativity for you. Impressive and dangerous.
Center chamber.
To go.
Ooh, looks like you found enough echoes. And you're not dead. Very impressive. I could put them to all sorts of use. Let's do it. Don't let the Draugr get you. Ugh.
missed his dinner up here. That's nice. Is that the armor? It looks kind of run down. Can you wear it?
No. It is too small and too old. We will bring it back to the dwarf.
Thank you.
that what I think it is?
Useless armor?
Useless? Oh, ye of little faith, this armor was worn by Ivaldi himself. Sure, it's seen better days, but I can restore it with more mist echoes, and it'll help with the effects of Ivaldi's curse.
Unless there is something of value in this workshop, there is little point in staying here.
You saw all the chests in the center chamber, yes? Plus all the goodies tucked away towards the back of the workshop? And the three realm tears, of course! But might want to be careful with those.
Why's that?
It's a literal tear in the fabric of reality itself. You want to reach your hand through there? Be my guest.